County, Georgia. Sheriff's vehicles pursue a two-bit car thief in a white Monte Carlo. But this chase will rewrite the book on high-speed pursuits. A team of three deputies are right on his tail, ready to corral this runaway felon. Seen from another cruiser, the pursuit becomes a battle when the suspect uses his car as a fuel-injected weapon. Charging into the opposing lane, narrowly missing cars, screaming through the night at 110 miles an hour. As the chase reaches a road construction area, the deputies prepare to make their move. But what happens next is so unprecedented, they're shocked and amazed. What appears to be an unmarked police car jams itself into the pursuit. It is actually a second stolen car, acting as a wedge between the cops and the fleeing white sedan. Inside this brown Caprice is the suspect's partner, determined to help his buddy get away.
They were working together. They weren't even expecting it out of the blue. It's one of those unexpected things that happened.
Metal meets metal as the deputy tries to ram him off the highway. The brown sedan is inches from skidding off the road. Incredibly, the driver yanks the car back under control, barely missing a traffic pylon. With the second thief running interference, his partner in the Monte Carlo has a real chance of getting away. Deputy has to take out the Caprice. That means putting his Crown Victoria against a vehicle so powerful and heavy, it is often used as a cop car. Again, chassis grind. But the plan backfires.
I was banged up pretty good. I went careened off into the woods 250 some odd feet.
This is what the deputy sees as his car hurtles off the road. Amazingly, the officer escapes major injury.
I am 10-4.
Meanwhile, the other deputies are relentless, bearing down even harder on the fleeing vehicles. The suspect can't shake the cops, and the speed is too much for him to handle. The Caprice rockets into a ditch, throwing up a shower of rocks and dirt as it flips over and over and over. Seen again, it's amazing that this automotive cartwheeling leaves the suspect with nothing worse than bruises. Honor among thieves comes at a high price. In the chaos, the thief in the Monte Carlo gets away. But his partner will spend 5 years in jail, paying for his buddy's freedom. As for police, they are given a wild introduction to a new breed of chase.